after discussion about this post-World War IV situation, we are now switching over to another topic that is also very closely related with World War II, that is development of dictatorship in Europe. Keep in mind that Hitler was not only dictator in Europe. As we are aware that in 1917 there was revolution in Russia. First Kerensky got power, and then there was second revolution in Russia where Vladimir Lenin, that is Vladimir Ilya Ulyanovich, got power in hand, and he emphasized more on dictatorship. Like that, first during war, that World War was not ended yet. No doubt Russia was out of war, but World War was not ended yet. And then at that period only, a development of dictatorship government, communist but dictatorship government, was developed in Europe, that is in Russia. Then onwards, as we discuss, in case of Italy, there was development of dictatorship under leadership of Benito Mussolini. Now, if I want to discuss something about this dictator, then first I should discuss about Vladimir Lenin. His brother, elder brother, named as Alexander, he was actually involved in the act of assassination of Tsar. A plan was there, but at that time that plan was decoded, and Alexander was arrested. He was imprisoned, and then he was punished to death. At that time, Lenin was a child, not much grown, but he decided to kill or destroy entire Tsar's family. Tsar means ruler of Russia. The actually Roman word is there, that is called as Caesar. So that is corrupted in Russian as Tsar. Tsar Nicholas was the last Tsar here. Where Russian were having a party, a developed party there, that is Communist Party. Lenin, actually name is Vladimir. Vladimir joined his party. Father of Vladimir Lenin was a teacher, mathematics teacher. But Lenin studied out Karl Marx in his young age and joined Communist Party. And then onwards, he was involved in some communist act, and ultimately he was arrested and deported, or rather sent to Siberia. Siberia is towards north part of Russia actually. There he was deported. He got married with a lady having name Krupskaya, and he was there in Siberia. Then he escaped from Siberia by changing his name of on passport. Instead of Vladimir Ilya Ulyanovich, he changed name as Vladimir Lenin and escaped from Russia. He went to England. Then he controlled Communist Party from England. And ultimately, during First World War, he returned from England to Germany. And Germans, because at that time war was at peak, Germans were fighting on two battlefields at a time, that is one towards France and one towards Russia, which is not expected actually problematic for Germany. And so Germans were also in hurry to cease fire for Russia, because Germans were already much penetrated deeper inside the Russian boundaries. And then the first revolution was there under leadership of Kerensky, but they continued war. And then the second revolution was under Lenin, where first Lenin went to Germany, and from Germany he went to Russia. Then he gathered his forces and carried out second revolution in Russia, where communist power was there in hands of Lenin, and then he made ceasefire with Germany. Then onwards, he developed Russia first. Over 6 years, the communist, or that we are calling as Soviets, were developed. Land was taken over by government, and entire Russia was converted into communist ideology or communist principle. The workers and farmers rule was practically established here. At the time of revolution, many people were involved. Say, for example, revolution in Moscow, that was controlled there by Lenin. He was there in Moscow at that time. But another city was there named as Tsaritsyn. So that city was fought by a person having named Joseph Jugashvili. So that Joseph Jugashvili, he was also communist in nature. He was from Georgia. He was also deported to Siberia. He escaped from Siberia by taking name as Joseph Stalin. And in the revolution, he fought the battle at Tsaritsyn. And after revolution, the name of that city changed from Tsaritsyn to Stalingrad. So Stalin was holding out now power in hand. Much of the power was there in hands of Stalin. And after attack on Lenin, so Lenin was shot out by a lady. A pistol was there with her, and she shot out from very, you can say, minimum distance. And still Lenin survived. Nearly for 6 months he was alive. And then the power was practically controlled in hands by Stalin at that time. His second dictator here, who created literally Russia. Say, foundation was laid down by Lenin, but actually the preparation of Russia for superpower was achieved by Stalin. He was a great dictator. He was suspicious in every action. He was also acted brutally. It is said that many people were killed out by Stalin. But the another part that he achieved tremendous development in Russia, and the most important thing what he achieved, that is, he got victory over German dictator, that is Adolf Hitler. A practically or real victory over Adolf Hitler first time was gained by Stalin. Then onwards others also defeated him. But the first, when it was something looking like that Hitler is proving invincible for himself, at that time he was defeated, and a massive blow was given to Hitler there. That was achieved by Stalin. This is his, I can say, the most important achievement in the war field. Apart from that, his vision was also important. Russia was not that developed nation during that period. But after fall of Germany, he taken various scientists from East Germany, because East Germany was there in hands of Russia now. So he taken various scientists from East Germany to Russia. And Russian development was achieved. Even a field marshal Polus is the name of the person in charge at that time at Stalingrad. The battle of Stalingrad was fought by this Marshal Polus. Field Marshal was the title given by Hitler at last moment. But he surrendered out in front of Russian army. And then he was taken, but he was not insulted. He was given charge to make Russian army well trained like German army. This is the vision of Stalin. And that's why Russians were able to prepare nuclear bomb. Russians were able to prepare hydrogen bomb also. The space race was there. Russians were get advancement in space race also after that. And then you are aware that first satellite or say spacecraft, artificial satellite or spacecraft was achieved by Russia, USSR. The first life in the space was sent by USSR only. That was a female dog named as Laika. The first person in the space was sent by USSR only, named Yuri Gagarin. So this is the marvelous victory achieved by Joseph Stalin first, because his brutal work, that steel curtain, cruelty and all that, that is discussed. But these developments of USSR, actually we have to develop, discuss here. So this is about a Russian dictator. Now let us switch over to another dictator, that is Benito Mussolini. He was from Italy. Basically, he was a very clever person. In school days, he was a very clever student. He was a strong person, healthy person. And after finishing his education, he worked few days as a teacher. But he was having conflict with principal and ultimately left the job. Then he served as journalist for a while. And then he started creating his own political party, that is having name as Fascist Party. During First World War, he was having clear-cut concept that Italy should participate in the war, but not from Germany's side, must be from England's side. And he promoted that concept, and ultimately Italy managed to do that. When Italy entered in war, Mussolini advised every youth of Italy to join the war. And he was also young at that time. So he said, all right, I am also now making temporary pause of my newspaper, and I am also joining the army. And this way, Mussolini joined the army. In war, he was injured because of a blast of some cannonball over there. That cannon was overheated and still was in use. And then it was because of blast, he injured. He was there in hospital, and then it was said that Italy got victory in the war. And after this war victory, Mussolini came to civil life again. He participated in election, but he was not able to gain power after election. Now Mussolini started gathering the youth of Italy. He started giving different assurances to Italian public, and he glorified history of Italy, the Roman Empire and all that things he glorified, and promised people that this glory of Italy we can get again if you supported me. Me means Mussolini. And ultimately, he got march, because Communist Party was advancing in Italy, and that's why capitalist people were having problem. The industrialists and all that, they were having problem, and they also supported Mussolini. And then King handed over power in hands of Mussolini. Now Mussolini created certain problems in Italy, but people were ready, many people were ready to accept. Say for example, there was check over newspaper or media. We are saying that media is having freedom, but that freedom was seized. Every news published in newspaper should be certified or verified first by agency of government, and with that permission only you can publish out that news. So like that, restrictions were declared on media. All other parties were considered as illegal. Only fascist party was considered as legal. Like that, he carried out dictatorship mood. But still people were satisfied to some extent, because whatever promises Mussolini was giving prior to elections and all that, majority of them were achieved. So for example, after getting power, Mussolini was able to give jobs for many people. They were jobless. For them, Mussolini proved better. Mussolini was saying that we should have some islands in Aegean Sea. It is near Turkey. So simply, being from victorious side, he impressed, or say, I don't know what happened exactly, but he got some islands from Turkey on rental basis, or say lease basis. But the important thing, that islands were there in hands of Italy. So Italian people get satisfaction. And then there was actually formation of an international organization that is called as League of Nations, that was formed to prevent warlike activities. But Mussolini carried out war. He declared war and he started advancing against the nation. It is called as Abyssinia. Today it is called as Ethiopia. In old days, in those days, it was having name as Abyssinia. And he advances in Abyssinia. League of Nations was not having its own army, and therefore League of Nations proved inefficient in this matter. Now League of Nations was not having their own army, and so cannot resist at that time about these warlike activities of Mussolini. Ultimately, Mussolini's army reached till capital of Abyssinia, that is called as Addis Ababa. Mussolini used poisonous gas and ultimately get controlled over Ethiopia or Abyssinia. And then the most important thing was there, that after that, whatever the restrictions were given by League of Nations, they were withdrawn. Mussolini was promising out that we should get colonies in Africa. Abyssinia is there in Africa only. And so Mussolini got power, and after getting power, Mussolini get that colony in Africa. So whatever promises were given by Mussolini, that were also fulfilled in earlier part only. Italy was not getting a stable government, but that was also achieved by Mussolini. And like that, the what we can say basic idea developed, that democracy or dictatorship. So dictatorship is better than democracy. And like that, ideology spread out in Europe. Now similarly, in Germany, the situation was here. I had to come to a person who is actually, that person was capable of changing the maps of world. And the real key factor behind Second World War, that was Adolf Hitler. Many people are having concepts in mind that Hitler means only bad element. Yeah, to a certain extent, that is true. He fetched World War. Hitler was actually, to a certain extent, definitely, if I am considering the genocide achieved by Hitler, then Hitler was definitely a bad, I can say worst man. But if you are observing particularly the reforms for Germany carried out by Hitler, they are wise. These reforms are showing a really intellectual piece of working. Whatever the achievements carried out by Hitler within 1 year after getting power in hand, marvelous one. None of the democratic government is able to achieve that within 1 year, what Hitler was able to achieve in those days in Germany. Say at that time, nature of people also important. So German public at that time was standing behind Hitler. At that time, now no, but at that time yes. And therefore Hitler was able to achieve that success within just 1 year. He was able to finish unemployment in Germany within 1 year to 60% level. And within next 2 to 3 years, there was no unemployment in Germany. That was achievement by Hitler. But where that employment was going, is all where maximum were, not all, but maximum employment was there in the industry. That industries were producing out weapons, unknowingly to the workers, secretly, but these tasks were achieved. And that's why he was, we have to consider as bad person. So his development was there, but the employment, development, everything that was there towards side of war. So he was preparing for war only. If you are going through his autobiography, that is Mein Kampf, then he mentioned clearly that we have to defeat France first. We have to avoid war with England. But after defeating France, we have to expand naturally towards east side, that means towards Russia. And we have to develop our empire towards Russian side. That was basic idea of Hitler. Apart from that, the most important thing I should tell about Hitler, that Hitler was not connected with any royal family or noble family, nothing. He was son of ordinary government employee. For many years he wandered on the lands, on the street of Vienna. Vienna was Austria's capital at that time. Without a job, he was there. Over the period, he was not getting food to eat. That was his problem. And during First World War, he joined German army. And then onwards, he developed himself. And ultimately, he became dictator of Germany. That all things we are going to discuss in next part. Here just I am giving introduction of dictators in Europe. Next dictator I should talk, because we are separately talking about Hitler in next lecture. So next dictator I must talk, that was Ataturk Kemal Pasha. He was dictator of Turkestan or Turkey. After end of Ottoman Empire, you are aware that in First World War, that Ottoman Empire ended. And then this fellow got power in hand. And then he developed Turkey. He taken out Turkey from old era to new compatible era. That is his achievement, particularly for Turkey. And that's why Turkey people are calling him, or Turk are calling him Ataturk. Here Ata means father. In Sanskrit the word is Pita. In English it is, in their language, Turkey language, it is called as Ata. So Ataturk means father of Turk. Like that title is given to him. So that is Ataturk Kemal Pasha. Another dictator was developed in France, in Spain. His name is General Franco. So he was another dictator. To the surprise, this dictator was helped by Benito Mussolini and Adolf Hitler, practically. Whereas democratic government were always sympathetic towards democratic government in Spain, but they didn't work practically. Whereas General Franco was actually a leader, that is a military leader, he got power in hand with support of Mussolini and Hitler. So like that, dictators develop. In latter phase, in Portugal also, dictatorship developed under leadership of Salazar. So like that, these dictators develop in those particular era. So this is another important thing, particularly after First World War in Europe. So we are discussing separately Hitler in next lecture.